Hi there, and welcome. The University of Minnesota is what's called a research university. But have you ever wondered what that means? You've probably been asked to read research papers for a class, but have you ever thought about how to read them? And maybe you've thought, you know, I'd like to get involved in research someday. But did you know you can get involved right now? Research is a big, complex topic, and we're only going to cover a tiny part of it here. But first, I'd like to talk about some terminology. Sometimes when we think of research, we think of this. People in a lab standing at a microscope with lots of fancy equipment. What about digging through piles of old books? What about creating a lighting design for a stage performance? How about interviewing people in a remote village? All of these are types of research, but sometimes the term gets stuck with laboratories and microscopes. So we'll sometimes use words like scholarship or research and creative activities to better encompass all the types of research that happen on campus. Digging through piles of old books might not seem like a lot of fun, but what if you're finding journal entries that teach us about our changing climate? Creating a stage lighting design might not seem like research, but it can tell us a lot about our emotions and how we relate to each other. And interviewing people in a remote village lets anthropologists learn about other cultures and our shared experiences. And sometimes those remote locations are no more remote than an office, where anthropologists look at the culture of American office workers, for example. Campus is full of people who are engaged in research. They use a variety of approaches and methods and ask a multitude of questions. But in the end, the purpose of research is to broaden our understanding of the world around us and sometimes change the ways we relate to it. Researchers are part of a community, and together they build upon each other's knowledge, even when they disagree. Researchers share their knowledge with communities outside of the university. Those communities can broaden their own understanding and sometimes use those ideas to solve problems and take action. This track is composed of four modules, covering the types of research you're likely to experience as an undergraduate. First, we'll talk about how to find scholarly sources. Then we'll talk about how to read those sources effectively and efficiently. Then we'll talk about how to use those sources in a paper. We'll talk about citations and appropriate uses. Finally, we'll talk about what this research thing is all about, how it's funded, how it happens, and most importantly, how you can get involved today. You can work at your own pace and in whichever order you'd like. As you complete each module, you'll be awarded a badge. And if you complete all four modules, you'll be awarded the Research Foundations badge. Good luck, and let us know if you have any questions.